Hello again, and welcome to Nikki's Backyard Biochemistry. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about G, Gibbs Free Energy, and how that relates to reactions. Now, a lot of you might have already seen this guy, but today I'm going to put Gibbs Free Energy into very simple terms. I'm not even going to worry about that equation. In fact, to start with, I'm not even going to worry about G. I'm just going to worry about this guy, delta, or the measure of change. Let's say I start a reaction with some cherries. I've got 8 of them to start with. And then let's say the reaction proceeds. What? Now, I started that reaction with 8 cherries, but I ate 6 of them. So the final number of cherries I had was 2. Now, the way that we usually express change in a reaction like this is with this guy, delta. We can express delta, or the change in a reaction, is by taking the final number of cherries and subtracting from that the initial number of cherries. And in this case, that delta, or the change, will be a negative number, because the number of cherries we finished with was smaller than the number of cherries that we started with. So our delta cherries, in this case, is -6. But it's not just for a reactant being broken down that we use the delta. We also use it for when a product is being built up. And in this case, the final number of product, or here the number of blocks that we have, is going to be greater than the starting number of blocks. But we work it out the same way. The delta blocks is the number of final blocks that you had minus the initial number of blocks that you started with. And if you start a reaction with a large amount of reactant, and that, for any reason, gets broken down, Jimmy Destroyer! Then your delta will be negative. So that's the delta. Let's go now and have a look at the G. And here we are at the skate park. We're going to be here just exploring this G thing, man, this energy. Let's check it out. When I started, I was at the top of that little hill, right? So I had a large G. That was my initial, was something really large. When I finished and I rolled down, all of that energy got released. So the G for final, or my final amount of energy, down the bottom, it was a small G. What happened to my G? It was really big up the top. Oh yeah, all the energy, or the G, got released as I came down the slope. Now I've only got a little G. Delta G equals final minus initial. And in this case, if we start off with something large and we use that energy and we end up with something small, that delta G is going to be negative. I'm just going to do that on the other side as well, just to show you. Negative delta G. What that means, right, is that reaction was spontaneous. It released energy. All I got to do then is get back up to the top, right? The G will be big again, right? Okay, let's just do that, me and my little G here. Now, with that kite that I had, that kite, it needed energy. It needed an input of energy. It needed energy to get up and do work. That made it a delta G positive reaction. It was non-spontaneous. But by coupling those two reactions of me rolling down the hill, which was spontaneous and released energy, we can harness that energy from that reaction and we could use that energy to do work. And in that case, the work being done was, it was inputting that energy into flying the kite. So we've coupled two reactions so that that kite flying or that non-spontaneous reaction would go. Thank you so much for joining me. And remember, if your delta G is negative, the reaction is spontaneous. Thank you very much for joining me on Nikki's Backyard Biochemistry. I look forward to seeing you again. Yay!